You're listening to Full Time, and there's a huge, huge night of Cage Warriors action coming back to the Echo Arena on Saturday, the 1st of September. So we're just over a week away from it. I'm one of the men who's headlining it. Joins me in the studio now. It's a very good afternoon to Paddy the Baddy Pimblett.
How are we?
Yeah, good. Very good, thanks. Probably not quite as excited as you are, because another huge occasion for you in your home city.
Yeah, it's gonna go off once again, September 1st. Can't wait for it.
You're taking on Soren Back. Tell us a little bit about what this night means to you, because once again, you're headlining a bill in Liverpool for a world title.
Yeah, like I was saying, I can't wait, you know what I mean? It'll be 3 months of hard graft put into it, as well as all the year training I've already done, and it's going to be nice to get called a two-weight world champion at the age of 23.
It's not a bad CV to have, is it? And it's about 2 years since you won your first world title. You've changed weight division since then, so this time you're a lightweight. What does that mean in terms of weight and preparation for the fight?
Yeah, well, it's a £10 difference, the weight. So you do come up against bigger people, but I was killing myself to make featherweight, you know what I mean? I was losing 7-8 kilos overnight just to weigh in on that weight, and then I'd have to, like, I'd dehydrate myself, know what I mean? Now I'm only like 4 or 5 kilo off my weight, just off dieting, not off dehydrating myself and depleting my body, know what I mean? So I go into these fights fresh now. This is how it should be.
Yeah, because you did have a few problems, didn't you, with making weight towards the end of your time at that weight division.
Yeah.
There were times when you were throwing up in the ring and all that, and they're now behind you, and that's for the better for you as a performer.
Yeah, there is a... It'll make 5 rounds even easier, you know what I mean? If I can do 5 rounds after cutting 7-8 kilo overnight, I can easily do 5 rounds.
Go on, tell us how you lost 7 or 8 kilos overnight, because there'll be people listening going, I'd quite like to be able to do that.
No, you don't want to. You don't want to. It's a disgusting way to do it. Stop eating carbs like a week before and have your three meals a day, egg whites, chicken and veg with no sauce, and then chicken and veg again with no sauce. Do that Saturday, Sunday, Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, and then stop eating on Thursday at whatever time your weigh-in is the next day. So 3 o'clock, stop eating at 3. All this time as well, you've been drinking 8 litres of water a day. So your body keeps going to the toilet like you have been, and you're getting hot baths or a sauna. And like I've done it where I've lost 8 kilo just getting in a hot bath and then in quilts and a hot bath and then in quilts overnight. That's all I'm going to spew in the ring after it's finished.
Just sounds so brutal, and it's the side of boxing, MMA, all kind of martial arts that no one sees.
No, what, boxing don't even do it like that. Boxing, like, it's got to be regulated, and that's what needs to happen with MMA, because there's people that are well too big fighting at weight divisions where, like, it's a way of beating the system in MMA, you know what I mean? You can be when it comes to fight night, you can be like 20 pounds heavier than your opponent.
Why haven't they got that regulation, do you think? Or is it something that might come in soon?
Oh, yeah, I reckon it's something that could end up coming in the next few years, but you don't know, you never know, do you?
It's all for people's safety. We saw it with the last, the big UFC night we had here, didn't we, with Molly McCann, I think, missed weight, and Darren Till wasn't far off, was she?
Yeah, Darren missed it by a few pounds. And it is the hardest part of the sport, because I swear, the dieting is the hardest part, you know what I mean? Diet's like 80% of it, and then exercise like 20%, and like I've done it at one point over this fight camp, weight sound. Thought, yeah, I can have a little cheat on the weekend. Had a slice of birthday cake and that. Come in a few days later, like, £7 heavier. Just like, oh my God, what has happened? And then just working it back off, know what I mean?
It's ridiculous, isn't it, how your metabolism works in that. But as soon as you change your diet, it makes such a difference. And hopefully this move now is going to make you a much more effective fighter. Not that you weren't effective at the weight division you were at, but are you now looking forward to being able to show what you can do as well at lightweight?
Yeah, know what I mean? I've got a lot more tricks up my sleeve this time. Like I said, I've had a proper fight camp where I've just been training for Soren, know what I mean? Like, when I come back off being an Aldie from in January, and I trained for, what was his name, Alexis Savidis, when I trained for him last time, I only had like a 6-week camp, all rushed, know what I mean? I've got a game plan for this. I've trained it out at him. We've done all the different scenarios we can end up in this fight, and there's no way he beats me at all. Wherever the fight goes, he gets beat.
It's going to be such a good night. It's Radio City Talker. Paddy the Baddy Pimblett joining me to talk about it. It's a huge night in Cage Warriors 96 on the 1st of September. Tickets still available to see this at the Echo Arena. What's it like walking out as the main event fighter with your home city there watching you and all behind you?
It's unbelievable. Like, there's no feeling like it, I'll be honest. Yeah, I'm getting goosebumps now thinking about it. I always do when people mention it. There's no feeling like it, really. It's unbelievable.
And what are you thinking when you're standing there 20, 30 seconds before you're ready to go into the cage and you know it's business time, but you've got all those people behind you? How do you block them out?
You don't. I don't block them out, know what I mean? That's why I walk out with a smile on my face, touching everyone's hands and that, know what I mean? I enjoy walking out. It's boss. You get a mad feeling when you're walking out, and then when you get in there, you'll notice it. My face just changes and I'm just serious. Then I'm all about the fight, know what I mean? And then it's all about the fight until the fight's done and I've got my hand raised, and then it's all about celebrating, jumping in the crowd, everyone.
Yeah, I was going to say, we've seen how much those crowds do mean to you when you do win, because you just jump out of the cage and jump into them, don't you?
I do, like all my family, my friends and that, my teammates. They're the ones that have all helped me get here, know what I mean? If it wasn't for them, I wouldn't be where I am. So they're the first people that I want to celebrate with.
You've got a record of 14 wins, 2 defeats, beat Alexis Savidis, as you mentioned, earlier this year after quite a while out of the ring. Who's else is on the card with you this time, man? We've got a few other scouters on there, haven't we?
Co-main event is Lee Chadwick. He's defending his belt. There's two lads from our gym fighting, Anthony O'Connor and Elliot Jenkins. They're both lightweights as well. They're fighting on there. There's people like Nicholas Dolby fighting. There's another lightweight fight. Jack Granville, the person who beat Soren Bach, who gave him his loss. So there's a few interesting fights on it, to be honest.
Been getting some tips off him then?
I don't need no tips off no one. No one for nothing. I've got my coaches for that, and we're going to the top anyway, so it doesn't matter.
And obviously the party is going to be in full swing when you do finish, but you must be looking forward to it. Going to have some tickets to give away later in the week as well for this huge night. What's it going to be like? Tell us how are you going to win this?
Don't want to be giving nothing away, really, do I? But like I said, we've got a game plan. We're coming in, and if he wants to stand with me and swing us over and right, that's all he's got, and he can, and I'll pick him apart on the feet. If he wants to try and wrestle me, I'll end up submitting him. If I end up taking him down, which could always happen, I'll sit on top of him and punch his head in until the ref drags me off him.
And we've seen that you are a versatile fighter in the way that you get wins as well, which is so crucial going in against any opponent. But last time it was at Flying Triangle. We've had punches, we've had decisions, we've had all kinds of different stoppages from you.
Yeah, I'm a versatile fighter, you know what I mean? I'm not just, people think I'm just a submission artist, know what I mean? I'm not. I'm an MMA fighter. I never started just doing jiu-jitsu or wrestling or striking. I come to the gym to be an MMA fighter, and you can see that when I fight, know what I mean? I haven't just got one discipline where I fall back to it. I'm comfortable anyway.
It's going to be a brilliant night. It really is. September the 1st, down at the Echo Arena. Paddy, best of luck.
Thank you, fella.
I'm sure you don't need it anyway, but we'll get you on after you win that second world title,
yeah,
as well.
Bring this belt back in here, innit? Absolutely. Have a little look at the belt.